What I wanted to do was to find out some way of learning more about the older people I've cared for who were having a positive experience of old age, the good stuff, the successful aging. So I started studying and measuring successful aging, and I came to a definition of that instead of just disease and disability, as people being able to cope and choose their goals and accomplish the goals that meant something to them. There were two main things that promoted or predicted that: adaptation and transcendence. Well, adaptation is like coping. What transcendence is a late life change in how we see things, change in our perspective. The thing that surprised me was when you looked at adaptation and transcendence doing this job, transcendence did 2.5 times more than coping and adaptation did. If I find out that this persists over time, because I have to do another study that says it's not just at the moment, but it's something that people keep feeling, then we can do all kinds of interventions or programs or services to help promote transcendence. And we know some things that do that. One is creativity. Another thing is being in nature and being close to nature. Another thing are contemplative things like meditation and journaling, talking with each other, because this transcendence is a spiritual or existential factor. If we could do programs and services that focus on giving people more opportunity to grow transcendence, then we believe we could increase successful aging, and the kind of successful aging that doesn't go away just because you have disease or disability.